This low that pretty much came from the mid-Atlantic is now exiting, and it's going to continue to taper off in the next few hours, so you'll feel the difference. As far as the morning lows, we did tie a record last set in 1949. We tied that record at 48 this morning, and we had some more record numbers. We had some low maxes here. Check it out. All across the board, it's pretty much, again, unanimous that we've had it. Central Park, LaGuardia, JFK, Newark, as well as Islip. We haven't seen temperatures or felt temperatures this cold, and we are picking up some more moisture off to the west to Hudson Valley. We're seeing some clusters of those heavy downpours again. This is all because of this area of low pressure interacting with this trough. That disturbance there provided some added instability in the environment. So here's what we can expect. You may be wondering, when is this all going to clear out, right? Between the hours of 6 and 9 is when things are really going to start to wind down. Take a look at that. You can already see the back edge of the storm, and it starts to really move on out from southwest to northeast. Look at the position. Eastern end of Long Island, as I've been talking about, getting the brunt of the heaviest downpours, as well as the potential for the coastal flooding. We did have an advisory that's been lifted, but we're still looking at some spotty showers, mainly in the Hudson Valley close to around midnight. But again, things are starting to wind down between 6 and 9, and then it's like that misty drizzle thereafter with plenty of cloud cover. As a matter of fact, looks like we'll be stuck in the clouds for a little while, and then increasing sunshine throughout the day for tomorrow. So it'll end up being a pretty nice Memorial Day. Some more clouds rolling through, but staying dry on Tuesday. Upper 40s, low 50s, status quo there. And across the board, as a matter of fact, it's like heavy jacket kind of weather in some spots. 48 Newburgh, 49 Sussex, 51 Central Park. High, which is going to set up shop Western Atlantic. And why is that important? Well, by midweek, right on in through the rest of the week, it's going to supply us with not only that stable air, but that southwesterly flow pumping in that milder air. Late Wednesday into Thursday, we're looking at some showers. More showers are possible with a chance of rain. And then we'll leave you with our 7-day